So if you're in the process of rebuilding an automatic like the 4060E and you don't want to spend a bunch of money on some fancy tools, I got a solution for you. Because this tool I built for under a dollar. Stay tuned. So here's the reason why I built this tool. I need to push down this retaining spring to remove a small little snap ring. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take a measurement from the inside of this groove to the inside of this groove. Okay, so that's going to be about 6 1/16, maybe even a 1/32. We'll do 1/16 and we can kind of go from there. A lot easier to have to cut something when it's too long than the other way around. We'll cut it right there. All right, so this piece is a little bit wider, so I'm actually gonna knock this down a little bit to fit it in those grooves. So for the most part, I'm gonna try to use stuff that I have around the shop. This piece is fabricated, so that will go in just like that. The next step is going to be to drill a hole through here and insert the rod. I got this measured and center punched. Oh yeah. Okay, the next step is I ground all this stuff down. This was galvanized. You don't want to be burning that when you're welding. And I'm going to weld this square nut to this piece. I never thought I would need a 180 MIG. These welds show everything. So I got one more piece to make, and this is going to be a 4-inch piece that's going to lay over this PVC coupling. I'm making this bigger than it needs to be,
so I can actually use this to remove the low reverse spring retainer.
Now, I don't need that because I have this tool. But for you guys at home, if you make this a little bit longer, and then you make another one of these pieces just a little bit longer, you'll be able to use this tool for two different purposes.
So I got this piece drilled out and to size. The next thing I did is I welded a nut to that shaft. The last thing I'm going to have to do is weld this shaft to this nut. Mainly because I couldn't get a bolt that was threaded all the way through.
This tool is all done. All right, let's see this tool in action. First thing you're going to need is a 2-inch piece of PVC. The gap between the ring is right there. So we're going to pop this tool in so it doesn't interfere where we need to get in there with the snap ring pliers. A couple cranks. Then we will take our retaining ring pliers. There we go. All right. Okay, there's that ring. And all we do is just loosen this tool up. All right, push down a little bit. There you go. It's as simple as that. Now to put it all back together, you're gonna take your ring, and open it up, you're gonna drop it down. Okay, so it's just kind of sitting. Then we're gonna take our PVC, take our nifty tool that cost us nothing to build, and we're going to tighten it again. Now we will take a screwdriver and just punch this ring down into its groove. Make sure it's sitting in there. All right, take this tool out, boom. There you are. So that's all there is to it. So here's the two tools side by side. Now, as you can probably tell, this has already got a bow to it. Now, like I said, I use stuff that I had around the shop. If you wanted to make it a little bit fancier, you can do what this company did and actually use square tubing. And if you didn't want to thread this, you could do the same thing. You could basically weld the nut to the bottom of that. So there's a couple ways you can make this into a multi-tool. Now, I've already thought ahead and made this a little bit larger to fit a bigger PVC pipe, which I believe is a 3-inch. So ultimately, your biggest problem here is this piece is not long enough. So what you would do is you would get another piece, cut it maybe a 2-inch section, drill a hole through here, drill a hole through the new piece, notch that piece, and you're basically just going to make extension arms to get to this length. Now, if you were building something out of square tubing, you might be able to get smaller tubing to fit in there, kind of like an engine hoist, and you could just pull it out for the reverse and then push it in for doing the input.